Hey kids, it's me again, Russ the dog. I have a lot of fun toys that I like to chew on and destroy. Some are old and worn, and some are shiny and new, but I don't have favorites. Just like God doesn't pick favorites with us, no matter how many times we've messed up.
I hope that you guys are enjoying these dog videos as much as I am. It's kind of funny to sit and think, I wonder what's going through a dog's brain, right? Well, hi, my name is Kristen again, and I'm so excited to be back with you for week two of our What is Love series. In this series, we are talking about what true love actually is. The world has a lot to say about what love is, whether it's books or movies or TV shows, or maybe it's our friends or our family. So many people have things to say about love, but we are learning in this series about what love is from the inventor of love himself. Do you guys remember who invented love? Right, God invented love. He invented us and he invented love. And we are learning about what true love is with the help of our man's best friend. And who is that? Right, the dog. I brought my friend here again to help us figure out what true love actually is. If you guys remember last week, we talked about one aspect of God's love, and that true love is sacrifice, and it expects what? Right, it expects nothing in return. We talked about the cross and how Jesus died on the cross for all of our sins, right? No matter what, he died on the cross for those who would accept him and those who wouldn't accept him. He died on the cross for people that wouldn't even say thank you, right? He expected nothing in return from us. He did that out of pure love for people. And today we're talking about the second aspect of God's love. And if we think back to the dog example today, you might be thinking, but my dog looks different than that, right? Or my dog's bigger, or maybe my dog's smaller than that, or maybe your dog's a little puppy, or maybe your dog's a little bit older and you've had him your whole life. Or maybe your dog has spots or has different colors on him than that dog, or maybe your dog only has three legs, right? I've seen dogs that might have just three legs, or maybe they have different colored eyes. There are so many different types and breeds of dogs. And if you think about the ultimate dog lover, like I want you to think of the person that loves dogs more than anybody in the world. Maybe it's you, or maybe it's someone in your house. But a true dog lover loves all dogs, no matter what, right? They might go to a dog park and they might just be obsessed the whole time. They're like, oh, look at him and her, and I love him and I just want to take him home, right? They love every single dog no matter what. And that reminds me of God's love a little bit. Whenever we think of God's love, God doesn't show favorites, and the Bible actually tells us that. We're going to go ahead and flip to Romans 2 verse 11. So if you guys have your Bibles, I want you to go ahead and pull that out. And you can follow along with me. It's a really, really short verse, but one that I think is so powerful about God's love. It says, "For God does not show favoritism." I'm going to read it again. "For God does not show favoritism." That is so strange, right? Because our world is too good at this, right? Our world is really, really good at showing favorites. Maybe you have a favorite friend. Maybe you have a favorite teacher. Maybe you have, hopefully not, a favorite parent. Maybe you have a favorite sibling, right? We want a lot of times to strive to be the favorites, and we also have favorites. Maybe we try to be the favorite kid or the favorite student or the favorite athlete. We feel like there's like this small amount of love and we want to take it all for ourselves, right? Well, God's love is not like that. God has enough love to cover and wrap the entire world, probably like 1,000 times, right? That is how much God's love is, infinite. And God loves every single one of us no matter what. He doesn't care what we look like or sound like or how tall or short we are or how old or young we are. God loves every single one of us and does not play favorites at all. And he calls us to love other people the same way. It's 1 John 4, verses 19. Let's go ahead and flip there. It tells us a little bit more about how God calls us to love others. So it's 1 John 4, 19 through 20. It says, "We love each other because he loved us first. If someone says, 'I love God,' but hates a Christian brother or sister, that person is a liar. For if we don't love people we can see, how can we love God whom we cannot see?" Now this verse has a lot in it. This verse is kind of calling us out, right? It's really easy to say, oh, I love God, right? God created us, I mean, after all, and he's done a ton for us. So it's kind of easy to just throw it out and say, I love God. But this verse tells us that if we don't love the people that are around us and our brothers and sisters in Christ, so whether that's your actual brother or just whoever is next to you at church, if we don't love them, then it's saying that we don't truly love God. Because how can we love God, who we can't see, if we can't even love the people that are next to us, who we can see, right? Because God created all of us. God created that kid that annoyed you. God created your brother. God created the kid that causes a lot of mischief and trouble, right? God created all of us. And when we don't love other people, that is saying that we don't love God's creation, right? So God is calling us to love other people just like he did. God is calling us to not have any favorites. He's calling us to love people that look different than us, people that maybe are different ages than us, that are older or younger. He's calling us to treat everyone the same way, that we treat them all with loving care and respect. Now, the world is really, really bad at this. Just like they're bad at sacrificial love. If you think back to the dogs, right? A lot of people give up their dogs maybe because their dog got too old and they're like, they're not a cute pup anymore. I don't want you, right? Or maybe they're like, and that dog caused way too much trouble. I can't have him in my house. And so they get rid of them. Well, God's love is not like that. If God were to walk into an animal shelter, I think God would probably accept all the dogs, right? Actually, if we think about in the Bible, God used the weakest of all. God used women in the Bible who were seen as kind of useless and that they didn't have much power. God chose to use them. Or God chose to use the youngest brother in the Bible, right? He didn't use the strongest and most powerful. God used even the people that people didn't really like and people that they saw were weak. And that is God's love. God's love is for everyone. There's an infinite amount to go around. And that's the way we are called to love other people. When we love other people like that, they are able to see God inside of us, right? They're gonna walk around and be like, there's something different about that person. They're being really nice to someone who's being really mean to them. Or they're being really welcoming to someone that looks so different from them, right? That type of love is different than the world's love. That type of love is true godly love, and it's the type of God God is calling all of us to. When we recognize and understand God's love for us that way, we are able to then love others that same way. So my prayer and hope this week is that you guys would continue to pour out God's love to the world, that you would continue to pray in those hard times that where it's really, really difficult to love somebody, that you would reach out and pray to God and ask God for the love for others that he has for them. I hope that you'll join us for our last week where we talk about the third aspect of God's love and that we wrap up what true love really is. Thank you guys.
Wow, that's very interesting to think about. Just like me with my toys, love has no favorites and is for everyone. See you next week. Until then, I'll be eating peanut butter.